Are you in the dark about how and when eclipses happen? Well, you could find out with this new tilt on eclipses, with this science snack by the Exploratorium called Eclipse in a Cup. So in order to do this activity, you're going to need the following materials. So roll out your colorful clay into a ball that's going to represent the Earth, about a half an inch to 3/4 inch in diameter, and roll out another ball. In our case, we did it in white polymer clay that's about the quarter of the size of the Earth. What you need to do now is you need to make a stand for your Earth so that it is able to be lifted about halfway up to the midpoint of the Sun. And you can do that by cutting down a cup so that it can rest on it. So I'm going to take one of my tumblers and I'm going to cut it so that my Earth can rest at the proper height. Now that you set this up, push your Earth onto its stand. Make sure it doesn't roll around and it sticks to the cup. This is now known as your Earth cup. The next thing you need to make is your ecliptic plane cup. And the way you do that is you take another cup, put it between your Earth and Sun, and you're going to draw a line that is at the same level as the midpoint of the Earth and the Sun. And I'm going to mark the midpoint that is at the midpoint of the Earth and the midpoint of the Sun, and I'm going to twirl my cup around to make my ecliptic plane. Now what you're going to do is you're going to take your push pin and you're going to push it into your ecliptic plane. Make sure you don't dent your cup. Just push it in right on that line. Next, what you need to make is your tilted lunar orbit cup. This one, you're going to take another color pen. In this case, I'm going to use red. And you're going to draw a line near the brim, which is on your table, about a centimeter or about 3/8 of an inch above the table onto your cup. And the way I'm going to do that is, again, I'm just going to spin my cup around until your line meets up again. Take your model moon and place it on that circle. Now to assemble your whole device, you're going to first put down your Earth cup. On top of that, you're going to put your ecliptic plane cup, and on top of that, you're going to put your tilted lunar orbit cup. To do your first investigation, put down your tennis ball or model sun and put your eclipse device near it. So the first thing we're going to do is investigate how a month of lunar orbit will work in this model. So what you need to do is grab the push pin and you're going to turn your tilted lunar orbit cup counterclockwise. As you turn it, that is going to represent about a month or roughly 30 days of the moon going around the Earth. So the next investigation is we're going to investigate a year of this device going around and orbiting the Sun. But when I do this, I want to keep the lunar tilt roughly the same direction. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go around the Sun, but I'm going to keep that push pin pointed at a fixed point. In this case, I'm going to point it to the corner of the room there. So what I'm going to do is, again, I'm going to turn the moon around the Earth, and I'm going to move this around the Sun And if I can, I'm going to turn my moon around the Earth about 12 times during this orbit of the sun. I'm also going around the sun also in a counterclockwise motion. This time I'm going to do it, and I'm going to again turn my moon 12 times as it goes around the sun, but this time when I do it, I want to see where I can make the moon, the Earth, and the sun line up in a straight line. Just to let you know that there are many things that you might think are in a straight line but are not. So in this case, the moon and the Earth and the sun are not in a straight line. But if the moon is over here, the moon will be too high, still not in a straight line. If the moon is over here, too low, not in a straight line. So you need to find the places where the moon and the sun and the Earth all line up. Try that. So you're going to need the lights off for this next part. So when the lights are down, turn on your flashlight and have a partner hold the flashlight next to the sun at the midpoint. This is going to represent the rays of light coming off of the sun. You're going to orbit your Earth-Moon system around your sun and make sure you're orbiting your moon around your Earth and see if you could see any shadows cast by the moon onto the Earth or the Earth onto the moon. So you might have realized that getting these three celestial bodies in a line is not an easy task. There's only four locations in space during the year when those three celestial bodies line up. One is here. And when they line up in a line where the sun, the moon, and the Earth line up, that's known as syzygy. So over here they line up, and a couple weeks later, they line up again. But interestingly enough, it's not until about 6 months later that that lineup happens again. In this case, we have the sun, the moon, and the Earth line up. And 2 weeks after that, we have the sun, the Earth, and the moon line up. Those are the locations where you can have an eclipse. They happen 6 months apart, and they also happen when the moon crosses over that blue line called the ecliptic plane. That is known as the lunar node. When the moon crosses over, that red line crosses over that blue line, you can have an eclipse right now, and that would be a solar eclipse. Or in this point, you can have a lunar eclipse. So you can have a lunar and solar eclipse here, and you can have a lunar and solar eclipse about 6 months later over here, where the moon crosses over that ecliptic plane called the lunar node. So you might be saying, what does this model have to do with our real solar and lunar eclipses? Well, it turns out that the moon actually is tilted off from the ecliptic plane. It actually is tilted about 5.14 degrees off from the ecliptic. That is why eclipses are rarer than you would think. Also, this is not to scale. If this was to scale, the Earth and Moon system would be about this far away if this was actually the model of the Earth-Moon system. And this would be off about 5 degrees. So it's a kind of a rare event that you should witness if you have the opportunity to see a lunar or solar eclipse.